So after I completed my studies, I had no idea what I wanted to do.
I first heard about STEP through a university email, and I heard one of my friends speaking about it, and I thought, yeah, that sounds great.
And once I saw Germany, I knew this is what I want to do.
It was always my dream to go out to the world, out of my country. It was a bonus for me to go overseas, especially for Germany, because Germany is like known as a capital for quality and for efficiency. My friends and my family were all very excited because it is a big opportunity. Family-owned company. It's a medium-sized company. It's not a very big company, but it has it's all over the world. It's all over. It's in a lot of countries. When I was working for a Hering in Germany, I was working in the finance department, which also has its different parts, like the financial controlling, bookkeeping or accounting department, and financial planning department. So I got to work in all those departments within the past 6 months. And I gained lots of experience there, and I also went to work in the production technology department, which is where they focus on public toilets and concrete facades, just to get a brief overview of how the company works, basically. Yeah.
Ah, ich glaube, wir brauchen jetzt ungefähr 2000 Stück. Wir müssen das bestellen.
Ja, ich glaube, das ist schon ein kleiner Schock für Sir Mankela war, als er hier im Burbach, hier in unserem kleinen Ort angekommen ist im März. Es war noch sehr kalt und er kam aus der Wärme und die ersten Tage und Wochen hatte er im Büro eine Mütze auf, hat teils mit Handschuhen gearbeitet.
Got introduced to very friendly people. Like I saw the complete opposite of the stereotype that exists, that Deutsch people are not friendly, they just mind their own business, don't bother me, personal space kind of people. But people were very welcoming and friendly, like asking questions, you know, being inquisitive and being interested in what you do or where you come from. So for me it was very good and yeah, it was awesome for me.
My first day was such a shock. I got there and it was the sales meeting, the yearly sales meetings, and they were all in German. So for 2 days, about 6 hours a day, I was sitting there listening to German meetings. I could not believe it. I thought, oh, I need to learn this language quickly. What's going on here? I learned a lot about the products, I must tell you. So it was interesting in its own way. Understood a little bit, but it was a big shock to my system.
It's like a different work ethic in Germany. Like lots of efficiency, everything is done on time and everything is accurate. So I learned quite a lot from that.
They do something there and they do it right the first time. They're very direct, so if it is wrong, you're going to know straight away what's wrong and what you need to do to fix it. So I think that is, yeah, that's something which I learned there, which I appreciated a lot and I found which we as South Africans really can learn from. Yeah.
Also wenn man jetzt hier das ein Unternehmen hat und eine Niederlassung in Südafrika, dort ist es schwierig, denke ich, Fachkräfte zu finden. Das haben wir erst probiert. Und dieses STEP-Programm ist eine wunderbare Gelegenheit, um junge Leute kennenzulernen, um nicht gleich so viel zu investieren. Außerdem, das ist der zweite Aspekt, ist es einfach ein guter Weg, um den Leuten uns zu zeigen und zu zeigen, wer sind wir und was machen wir und einfach die Leute für uns zu begeistern.
I'm Johannes Capier, and I'm currently working here at Namibian Breweries. I work in the logistics department. Well, we're basically responsible for the international market, making sure that our products get into Africa, into Southern America, into Europe at the right time, the right price for your convenience. In Germany, I worked for Mercedes-Benz Daimler. I was based in Stuttgart, Sindelfingen. And basically, it was also in the logistics department. We were responsible of ordering parts, you know, from all over the world. No, definitely. The whole STEP program, you know, has been designed in such a way that it does not only focus on your on building on your education or your work experience, but it also gives you another insight into life. You know, it gives you personal growth.
I think Joe was fortunate to have been afforded this opportunity to go. You know, very few people do get opportunities like that. I wish I could have an opportunity at a similar age, and that would have been great for my career at the time. But having said that, I mean, Joe had the opportunity. He's made the most of it, and I'm happy to say that from what I've experienced with him the last 11 months or 10 months or so, he's sort of benefited quite substantially from the program. And if you ask me, I wouldn't love to lose him. I'd hate to lose him, in fact. That's in a nutshell.
No, and you get a broader idea, you know, of how life really is. And once you come back, you really see yourself as a changed person.
Mercedes-Benz South Africa started its collaboration with the SAFRI organization about a decade ago. And one of the programs that we got involved in was the STEP program. And the STEP program was very interesting for Mercedes-Benz South Africa at that stage because it provided a platform for recently qualified graduates to actually get some working experience abroad. And, you know, in South Africa, it is very difficult for somebody who's recently qualified to get a job. And this program was very interesting from that perspective, because it was really a cool way of really affording somebody a platform to get experience, learn a new language, work in another country abroad for 6 months.
My name is Jason de Plessis. I'm 23 years old. I come from a small place called Cape Town, South Africa. I studied at the University of Stellenbosch, obtained my honours degree in BCom Logistics in 2011. I'm currently working now at Mercedes-Benz South Africa, working in the logistics division, and I'm part of the STEP program 2012. The journey itself was quite rewarding, learned so much. So. This experience has broadened my eyes to a world beyond the borders of South Africa. I have learned that I should not be constrained by the difficulties and challenges that my country faces, but that I should take what I've learned from this experience and implement it in my daily and professional life.
And I think today probably over 50 people, young South Africans young people from the SADC region who would never have had an opportunity to work overseas now have got an excellent opportunity to work overseas, and many of them recruited gainfully within Mercedes-Benz, our own employees, and elsewhere in the SADC region. So it's been a long time, but it's one of those programs that you can really be proud of.
What the future holds, I don't have a clue. Hopefully it will only have good things. I had a great start or introduction to my working career, and hopefully I'll continue.
Ich komme aus Harare, Zimbabwe.
Ich komme aus Mauritius.
Ich komme aus Jeffreys Bay, Südafrika.
Ich komme aus Botswana.
Ich komme aus Madagaskar und wohne in der Hauptstadt Antananarivo.
Wir sind wieder zusammen nach 6 Monaten. Viel Zeit ist vorbeigegangen. Die Praktikanten haben viel gesehen, gelernt und erfahren bei ihrem Praktikum in Deutschland.
Ich habe bei der Daimler Corporate Academy in Möhringen gearbeitet.
Ich habe für 2 Monate in der Buchhaltung gearbeitet mit Herrn Schäfer. Das war mein erster Tag im Büro mit Obst und Blumen. Aber ich finde das interessant, weil in den nächsten Wochen gibt es kein Obst und kein Blumen. Ich muss das selbst holen, aber...
Living in an extremely new country, very different to my own, learning the language and adapting to a dissimilar culture was exactly what I needed.
Today, I stand in front of you, a person altered from what I've been 6 months ago.
Ab Mitte September werde ich in Durban für Hering Südafrika arbeiten. Ich hoffe, dass ich neben der Arbeit einen Master in Finanzen machen kann.
Der Weg ist geebnet und ich bin gespannt, durch die Türen, die dieses Tierprogramm für mich geöffnet hat, zu gehen.
Ich sage nicht Lebewohl, sondern auf Wiedersehen. Dankeschön.
Well, in these 8 months I was doing an apprenticeship, so I got a little snippet of every area of the company where I was. So for these next 8 months I'm really going to be focusing on sales and on our new projects, and I really want to be able to, how do you say, sink your teeth into it and get that experience of what this really is, not just a broad overview but yeah, more in depth of how this works and what we actually need to succeed in this business.
Well, the next step for me is to work here and to develop myself here at Hering and to possibly make a difference in Hering, because they've done a lot for me through the STEP program. Like, they've hosted me, they gave me a job opportunity, they trained me, they invested a lot in me, so it would be only fair for me to give back and to try to help build the company.
I think it's a really good program, and if it should continue, it should continue on a larger scale, because there's so much potential in Africa of people who've just graduated and people who need such international experience. So if it could continue on a larger scale with more companies taking on Southern African students, that would be great.
Die junge Bevölkerung wächst sehr stark. In dieser Jugend und den mit ihr verbundenen Talenten liegt ein herausragendes Potenzial und eine riesige Chance für den gesamten Kontinent. Dieses wachsende Potenzial an Talent in tatsächliche Erfolge umzuwandeln, ist eine Aufgabe, die nur Politik, Wirtschaft und Zivilgesellschaft, nur nationale und internationale Partner gemeinsam umsetzen können.